I'm Barbara Dixon, and this is Anna Belcher, and we're with Southern Bancorp Bank. Southern is a different kind of bank. We are a designated community development financial institution, and our main focus, our mission, is to be involved in and serve the community. And what makes us different is we offer traditional banking services, but we also offer other services that help strengthen our community, to teach them financial literacy and to help them to build credit, understand credit, and to make good, wise choices. Some of the programs we offer, we have a learning center that covers everything from savings to loans to small business, housing. There's also a section of that website that is designated for youth that's broken up by age groups, so you can get financial literacy information for your children on that website. There's a section for senior citizens as well. We also offer a free credit review. We will help you pull your free credit report, go over it with you, give you the resources to review it and to know what to look for. We offer a credit builder CD loan to help you start building credit history or to improve your credit history. We also offer free counseling services, whether you want to just do a budget or just ask questions. That service is free, and it's all free to customers and non-customers alike. We offer free home ownership counseling services. We offer free income tax preparation through the VITA program. It's a voluntary income tax preparation assistance program. And for consumers who qualify, we prepare their taxes free. We will be doing that right here in the Locksburg branch. A lot of what Southern does is they try to strengthen the community, the businesses and individuals alike. And we are considered, one of our models is to be wealth builders for everyone. And one of the primary ways we start that is by teaching savings habits. And Anna is going to tell you a little bit about some of those.
We have a few savings products that's going on right now. One is our Roundup Savings. Every time you use your debit card, you can either round up to the next dollar amount, or you can round up a certain dollar, whether it's one or five, just whatever is convenient for you. And we also have what is called an app that you can download, and the app is called Envy. And it is a savings game. It's a 100-day process, and you determine how much you want to save in the 100 days. And every day that you go into the app, you open the envelope, and it may transfer a dollar, it may transfer $2. Whatever is in that envelope on that app that day is how much it transferred to your savings account. We also have what we call a CD credit builder loan. If you are just starting out and getting credit, or you've just graduated from school and you're having a hard time getting credit because you have no credit score, or even if you've had past negative credit, then you can come in and we can start you out with credit of a CD loan, and that also gives you a CD. When you pay your loan off, that CD is your money. And Southern believes in Sevier County. We believe in empowering our community, and we are thankful to be here in Sevier County, and we look forward to serving Sevier County and the people in this community for years to come.
And welcome to the Bank of Locksburg Historic Gymnasium in Locksburg, home of the UA Cossetot Lady Colts, getting set for opening round action of the NJCAA Region 2, Division 2, Region 2 basketball tournament. which is being played. Opening round games are being played in a variety of locations. The lower seed, of course, UA Costat finished, I guess, fourth in the conference, and we're winding up playing against National Park, a team that we split a couple of games with this season. First time we got together, conference opener back in January in Hot Springs, Lady Colts ran into a buzzsaw. National Park wound up winning that game by 10. But the next time we got together, back at the first of, February 4th here in Locksburg, that game was pretty one-sided. Lady Colts jumped out to a 7-point lead after the first quarter and just built on it after every quarter, wound up winning by 29. And it's one of those situations, when you look at the conference, and even though UA Costat's getting a home court advantage tonight, you know, I'll be honest, it's not fair. I mean, these two teams split, and you would think a conference tournament would be played in a neutral place. It was my understanding we were going to be playing like at Harding University. Everybody has to travel, and everybody is on a court that is not their own. And, you know, really and truly, that's the fair way of doing things. I don't know what happened. I don't know who dropped the ball. Maybe this was the plan all along, but it just doesn't seem fair that a team like National Park, who split with UA Costat, is going to have to come over here and play on a court where they had one of their worst outings of the season. So, that being said, it's not the first time that Region 2 is, you know, a conference tournament has rolled around. If you go back to the COVID year 2020, we wound up, I guess it was 2021, we wound up playing a conference tournament, but there were teams that hosted the tournament, and because of COVID, they wouldn't let visiting fans in. So even though you had to drive across, you would have wanted to drive across the state to support your favorite team, you couldn't be in there because of COVID concerns. And yet those teams that were hosting weren't concerned about their own fans being there. It's like if you're the visiting team, your fans are dirty and you can't come in here. I still got to burn my saddle about that one. But it's here we are today. And again, anybody from National Park fans are going, you know, it just doesn't seem fair. I get it. I truly do. And even though the conference couldn't play their tournament at Harding University, you would have thought Central Arkansas, which is the perfect place, anywhere from Conway to Searcy to, to Hot Springs even, Pine Bluff, anywhere in that circle, there's got to be a high school gym there somewhere. If you can't do it in a college gym or a municipal gym, there should have been some place that would have been suitable to host this tournament. That way everybody has to travel, and we're all on an equal playing field when you get there. Nobody's playing on their home court. But, okay, I'm getting off my soapbox. We are here tonight, and we're glad you're joining us here on ed88radio.com. We're still about 17 minutes away from game time. Just wanted to check in, let you all know what's going on. We'll have UA Costat's Lady Colts taking on the Nighthawks of National Park coming up on ed88radio.com. In the meantime, we want you all to meet our new soccer coach here at UA Costat.
For a fun fact of the day here on Ed 88, brought to you by Don's Easy Pay. In our studio today, from left to right, we've got Coach Stan Sumner of the UA Costat basketball, our head coach and athletic director. Right beside him, one of his newest employees, he would be Justin Hinman, who is our brand new soccer coach here at UA Costat. And another guy over here who he's our friend to some, but he's all of our bosses. He is the one and only Dr. Steve Cole. Hi, Steve.
Hi.
I know you can't wait. You're chomping at the bit to talk about this game.
I really am. I'm to talk about both of these gentlemen and Coach Moore. Coach Moore's back there in the room, but he's our associate head women's coach. And you know, we started growing athletics at UA Costat. We did that. We're doing it organically. You know, we started 5 years ago with basketball. We're slowly growing. Now we've added shooting sports, and now, you know, something that we're just really excited about, you know, because of, you know, our local area. I mean, we're a hotbed for soccer. We are. I mean, of all places in the state and the region, you know, in and around DeQueen, Nashville, all around the greater Southwest Arkansas area, it's soccer. And Coach Hinman comes to us. He's our very first head soccer coach. He'll coach men and women's soccer beginning in the fall. And right now, he is already on campus. ready to start building this program. The signing period for NJCAA athletes is in February, and so between now and next fall, he'll be building his men and women's squads. And so we're excited to have Coach Hinman. He comes to us ready to go. I mean, he wants to build. He's a builder, and he wants to build here.
All right. Well, Justin, first of all, thanks for visiting with us today. Congratulations. Welcome aboard. Welcome to the Casa Todd family. Tell us a little bit about yourself.
I am excited to be here. I mean, it's a great soccer area, and I'm Arkansas native, born and raised in Little Rock. I went to Catholic, of course, and Rocket. It's a good state. I feel like there's not a lot of chances so far, and I think this is a great opportunity to expand soccer and put the Queen on the map. And I'm excited. I'm ready to make UA Casa Todd a well-known school in the soccer world.
Well, one of the things that really impressed us, Coach Hinman, in the interview process was the fact that we played the Queen back in the past. We know about, the quality of soccer that's played down here. It's got to be exciting to come to a community where, that is the sport in this town.
Yeah, I mean, it's a great thing. I mean, I remember playing back in my Catholic days. I mean, we played the Queen every single preseason. I remember I was like, They're good. This is a really good school. Why is it like, I feel like, where are these kids going to go play college and all that? And I mean, I think it's a great spot. I mean,
and you're right, in the interview process, and we all sat through that interview process and participated in that. We knew we were looking for a particular person. First, we wanted to have a person that wanted to be here. Just like Coach Sand and his family, they moved here. They wanted to be here. And when Coach Hinman, when he saw and this was advertised, I mean, he's already moved here. He's moving here today to be part of our community. And so that often says a lot. And he wanted to do that. And he's already talking to some of the, folks that help organize soccer in the area. He's already talking about having camps, not just for college or high school kids, but for young kids, where we can start a real big, solid soccer program, here in Southwest Arkansas, not just to Queen, but all over Southwest Arkansas. I mean, there's soccer players in Texarkana, there's soccer players in Nashville, to Queen, Broken Bow, Ida Bell. It's a Cossetot River. I mean, it's a big soccer hotbed, and Coach Hinman, he moved here already to start, and we're all going to help him.
Well, one of the things, and you mentioned the help. One of the things we talked about during the interview process, you're going to find a whole network of folks out there that are chomping at the bit. Can't wait. Got brand new fields coming online, and there are plenty of people out there that played soccer that want this. They want a college-level program right here, and we're about to have it and be one of the few in the state. It's going to be awesome, absolutely awesome. Now, Stan, I know, first of all, congratulations on behalf of the Lady Colts. Oh, my goodness. Are they playing some good basketball right now or what?
Yes, they're playing some great ball. Thank you to all the support, the fans, and everybody in the community. The kids are doing a great job, and we're pushing to keep extending and growing in the game and keep getting better.
I mean, the last couple of games, you've beaten teams that had beaten y'all earlier in the season. And I tell you, going to ASU Mid-South this weekend, that's beautiful. I mean, it's hard to win there.
Yes, yeah. No, it was a great win. I mean, we came out slow to start off, but then the girls settled down, and we won every quarter from that point, and we won the game. So very excited and happy for our kids.
Well, I bet you're excited about having this soccer program rolling and having the right guy in the spot.
Yes, no, it's exciting to have Coach Hinman on staff with us now. I think he's going to do a great job here. He's going to have a lot of help as well. He has great ideas, has a bright mind. Wants to grow the soccer here in Arkansas, so we're thankful and grateful to have him, and he wants to be here, so that's always a good thing when the person of the job wants to be here and ready to get things going.
Okay. All right, Coach Hinman, any final words, any final thoughts as we get set to, I mean, you're going to walk out that door and you're back out at it again.
Yeah, I mean, I'm excited to be here. I'm thankful for the opportunity, and I mean, the community seems great. I've already had countless people reach out like, when are we doing this? When are we doing this? Let's get the youth program going. And I'm ready for it all. I mean, I'm ready to grow the soccer around here, and I'm ready to get it going.
And anyone interested in playing soccer at UA Casa Todd, this is the guy to talk to.
Reach out. I'm here.
We'll have a home for an awful lot of athletes starting this fall. And, it's time to recruit. So be a Colt and be part of something special.
I think you can see the energy. There's a lot of it. So anyway, we're looking forward to it. Welcome aboard, Coach.
Thank you.
And that is our fun fact of the day, brought to you this morning by Don's Easy Pay here on 888.
And we welcome you back as we're getting set here in just a moment to get things underway. It's still about 10 minutes away from tip-off. But the Lady Colts, prior to this contest, will be honoring their three sophomore players, and as well as, I believe, here we go. Hey, Barry.
Letter from the coach to our sophomores. Let me do that first. It's a letter to our sophomores from Coach Stan, Danielle, and Isaiah. To our sophomores, thank you for a wonderful year. It was a challenging year with a lot of changes. Each of you stuck by us and Coach Moore, and for that, we're forever grateful. Thank you for your leadership, hard work, dedication, determination, both on and off the court. We know each of you are destined to do amazing things, and we cannot wait to see what the future holds for all of you. While we are sad to see you all go after this year, you all have made a huge loving imprint in our hearts. A huge thank you to your parents and families for all of their support. Without them, none of this would be possible. Special thank you to Dr. Cole, Lauren, John, especially John, Barry, Mike, Kelly Plunk, Crystal Sims, Erica, student ambassadors, and all UA Costat staff who played a huge part in this season. Amari, Kayla, Kyler, and Jay Wright, we wish you the best on your future endeavors. Let's finish strong and continue to make UA Costat history. With love, Coach Stan, Danielle, and Isaiah. Now for our sophomores, this is in no particular order. I'm going down the lineup here. Amari Morrison, sophomore out of Church of Kenny, Texas. Kyler Hardy, sophomore out of Murphy, Texas. And Kayla Fuller, sophomore out of Princeton, Texas. Is Jordan here? Jordan Wright from Fort Smith, Arkansas. Get a picture all together.
And this is my McDonald's order. I get a Big Mac, Chicken McNuggets, fries, and a Sprite with sweet and sour and barbecue sauce. But I like to mix it all up. So I'm gonna put some fries on my Big Mac. Or top my fries with Chicken McNuggets.
That's right.
Or make a totally new sandwich like this. As long as you're doing you, you're doing the sweetie, man. Order ahead on the McDonald's app.
Hey, Jake from State Farm. I want that personal price plan. So how's this for personal? I draw mustaches on players' faces when they're asleep.
Coach Reed. You don't need to get that personal to get the State Farm personal price plan. It helps you create an affordable price just for you.
Oh, Coach, it happened again. I'm gonna get to the bottom of this.
Call or click to get a quote today. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
If it's an outage, you should report it to SWEPCO using their mobile app. But if you're looking to replace your light bulbs, I have an idea. You should consider changing to LED bulbs. They use at least 75% less energy than traditional bulbs, which means saving you a lot of money. They can also last at least 25 times longer and emit very little heat. You can also get LED bulbs that change color, are remote controlled, and they can even play music. They'll even drive your kids to summer camp. So what are you waiting for? Switch to LED bulbs today.
UA Cossetot Physical Therapist Assistant and Occupational Therapy Assistant programs in Ashdown are designed to give our students the skills needed to be job ready in only 30 months. At UA Cossetot, our instructors are knowledgeable and experienced, our classes are affordable and small, and our facilities are big and well equipped. And you'll find our graduates on the job all over the Four States area. And that's something to celebrate. Application deadline is March 1st. UA Cossetot, your career starts here. And we're still about 4 minutes away from game time here at the Bank of Locksburg Historic Gymnasium. Lady Colts get set to take on National Parks Nighthawks. Opening round action. The NJCAA Division II Region II Tournament. Lauren Hinton courtside. Kelly Plunk on the camera tonight. Yeah, she's fired up about this. It's all just what she's been dreaming of all season long, was to be the camera person.
Yes.
Anyway, last time these two teams got together, back on February 4th, here in this gym, Lady Colts, as we said, came away with an 84-55 victory. And in that game, the Lady Colts just one of the players that really stood out that night and loosened things up from the perimeter, Kiana Holly, hit 3 3-pointers in that ball game, wound up with a dozen points. But Carmella Hayden had one of her best games of the season. Now, Carmella, of course, is a point guard, triggers the offense. And she's one of those kids that, given a chance to pass or shoot, she'll pass 9 times out of 10. That night, she was hot. She was like 9 out of 16 from the field, finished with 22 points on the night. And somebody else that stood out that night was Jerry Cotton, who came off the bench and hit for 13 points that night, including 5 out of 7 at the free throw line. Also on that night, Kayla Fuller, who, by the way, is the all-time leading scorer for the Lady Colts program. And granted, we've only been doing this for about 4 years, but she's amassed a lot of points in the 2 years she's been here. Anyway, she had 17 that night. And, of course, the Lady Colts typically, they've got, 5 players that average in double figures, led by Fuller with 13 points a game. Meanwhile, Samaya Smith, Kyler Hardy, Amari Morrison, and Carmella Hayden all each average about 10 points a game, while National Park, on the other hand, that particular night when we got together, it was not a lack of their frontliner scoring. It was they just didn't get a whole lot of help from anyone else. India Atkins, who's had a lot of good games against Cossetot over the past couple of years, she wound up the night with 21 points. Another good night for India. Meanwhile, Amaya Coakley, who normally averages 13 points a game, she wound up with 11 that night. 10 points for Jyla Calvin, and 10 points for Katie Pleasance. But other than those 4 players right there, only one other player scored. Ashley Blaylock added 3. So I'm thinking if they're going to see you, Danielle. If they're going to be successful tonight, they're going to have to find some more scoring. Meanwhile, the Lady Colts, they've been very, very good on their home court. 8-5 on the season, 16-13 on the year, 4-6 in conference play. Meanwhile, National Park 9-14, 3-7 in conference, but only 2-8 on the road. So we buzz the buzzer. We'll be back in a moment with our national anthem and starting lineups here on ed88radio.com.
Cossetot Colts merchandise is now available at the ERCs in Dequeen, Ashdown, and Nashville. Come on in and let our friendly staff show you around. We have a lot to choose from, including t-shirts in a variety of styles and colors, caps, hoodies, polos, long sleeve t-shirts. We have joggers and stuff like coffee mugs and insulated thermal tumblers, as well as flash drives, lanyards, and power bank chargers. Just let the staff know what you need, and who knows, they might even model it for you. Show your Casa Tot school spirit. Get your Colts merchandise today at an ERC near you.
Starting lineups tonight, first of all, for visiting team, the Lady Nighthawks. Sophomore guard, double zero, India Atkins. Freshman forward, number three, Ramisha Griffin. Freshman guard, number four, Sydney Townsend. Sophomore forward, number 23, Jyla Cowan. Freshman forward, number 24, Ashley Blaylock. Now for you. Now for your UA Casa Tide Lady Colts starting lineup. Ed guard, 5'5 freshman from Dallas, Texas. Number one, Carmella Hayden. And four, 5'10 sophomore from Texarkana, Texas. Number 15, Amari Morrison. And four, 5'10 sophomore from Murphy, Texas. Number 25, Kyler Hardy. And guard, 5'8 freshman from Rayville, Louisiana. Number 30, Maya Smith. And a guard, 5'9 sophomore from Princeton, Texas, number 32, Kayla Moore.
And we're set to get underway as the Lady Colts and the Nighthawks get set to open up conference tournament. Here at the Bank of Locksburg Gymnasium. Got a decent crowd on hand tonight. Folks still coming in, all getting off of work. That's a good thing about a 7 o'clock tip-off. Get a chance to get a few more people in the gym. Got a few folks making the trip down from Hot Springs. One of these teams will move on in the conference tournament. The one-team season will be over. As the opening tip is controlled by the Lady Colts. Kyler Hardy gets it in the hands of Carmella Hayden, and here come the Lady Colts on offense. Working against a 2-3 zone. Hayden backs it out. They'll work it right wing. Samaya Smith fires it inside. Kyler Hardy goes strong to the basket. Actually, it's Amari Morrison with the basket. Morrison gets her first two of the night, and the Lady Colts break on top, 2-0. Lady Colts put pressure up top. Pass tipped away, picked up by Morrison. Morrison lost the handle. Lady Colts chase it down. Hardy gets it back up top to Hayden. Works it left side. Smith all alone for the three. Can't get it to go. Rebound. Tipped out. Bounce pass. Down low. Fuller. Strong to the basket. Can't get it to go. She's going to the free throw line. Nice feed over there by Morrison into the hands of Fuller. She will be fouled. That's going to be called against Cornisha Griffin. Griffin called for her first personal foul. and head to the free throw line will be the Lady Colts' all-time leading scorer, Kayla Fuller. Fuller puts it up and in. Lady Colts on top, 3-0. Fuller will have another one coming here. Just underway, 9:16 to play in this first quarter. Shot on the way won't go, and the rebound is going to be hauled down by Sydney Townsend. Townsend gets it up top. Try to work it over in the corner. Lady Colts putting pressure on that ball. They'll work it down low. Pass tipped away, picked up by Samaya Smith. Fires it ahead. Fuller gets it back to Smith, back out to Hayden, and Hayden will set the offense. Just under 9 minutes to play first quarter. Lady Colts inside, tried to get it in the hands of Morrison, couldn't quite control that pass. The ball goes out of bounds, turnover Lady Colts. 8:47 to play first quarter. Lady Colts on top, 3-0. India Atkins with the basketball. Working out there against Fuller. Gets it in the hands of Calvin. Now we're getting left side. 12-footer on the way will not go. The rebound's going to be chased down by Samaya Smith. Good hustle that time by Smith. Gets it over to Hayden. Carmella crosses the horsey head at midcourt. They'll work it right side. Fuller with it. Out on the wing. Gives it left side. Smith takes a dribble. Gets it back out. As Fuller, she'll take the three. No. Rebound tipped around and chased down by Morrison. Morrison puts it up, rattles it around, and it goes down. Morrison with a basket. She's got four. Lady Colts on top, 5-0. Just under 8 minutes to play first quarter. Nighthawks with it, left wing. They'll try to attack. Into the lane, collision, no call. Rebound pulled down by Hayden. Carmella will pull up in the backcourt. Works it across the midcourt stripe. Bounce pass, right side, Fuller back out to Hayden. Hayden works it, left side. Smith, now they'll get it over to Fuller, back out to Hayden. Tries to attack, kicks it back out to Smith. Looking inside, wanted to get it to Kyler Hardy down low. Pass tipped out of bounds, last touched by the Nighthawks. Lady Colts will put it in play on the baseline. They're up 5-0, 7:23, first quarter. Bounce pass on the inbounds pass. We've got a whistle down low on the inbounds pass, and a personal foul is going to be called against Jyla Calvin, that is. Calvin called for the personal foul. And the Lady Colts will have it. Second team foul against the Nighthawks. Inbounds pass goes to Hayden. Hayden out to Smith on the perimeter. Fuller, left wing, back up top. Hayden to Fuller. Fuller tries the three from the left side. That one won't go. And the rebound is going to be hauled down by Calvin. Jyla gets it ahead to India Atkins. Atkins on the attack. Oh, nice give inside. Had the right idea. But getting a hand in there defensively and deflecting the pass off the offensive player. That was Kyler Hardy. Good defense that time by Hardy. Nighthawks turn it over. Lady Colts get it back. 7 minutes to go. First quarter. Lady Colts on top, 5-0. Bounce pass right side. Smith back over to Hayden in the corner. Fuller, Hayden. 17 seconds on the shot clock. Running jumper won't go by Smith, and the rebound is going to be chased down by Blaylock. Long three-pointer on the way. No good. Rebound tipped around, picked up by the Nighthawks. Another three. That one off the glass and good. Deep in that left corner, and the Nighthawks are on the board. Give the basket to Calvin. That's her first points. Actually, the first points by the Nighthawks tonight. Nice defense that time by Calvin. Ball is tipped out of bounds off of a Lady Colt player. Nighthawks get it back, trailing 5-3 with 6:20 to go, first quarter. Atkins to Calvin. Gets it out on the right wing. Townsend, back left side. Atkins will try the three. That's an air ball. A little bit out that time. Atkins says, that's on me. Might have wanted to be a step a little closer that time. Lady Colts get it, leading 5-3, 6:05 to play, first quarter. Smith gets it out to Hayden. Hayden attacks, pulls up, and a travel is called on Hayden. I bet you could count her number of travels on one hand this season. Very, very good ball handler. One of the things I noticed in the preseason, Lady Colts between Smith and Hayden had a couple of really good guards. Nighthawks with it. They'll get it in that left corner. Three-pointer on the way. Off, no good. The rebound's pulled down by Samaya Smith. Smith on the run. Tries the left side instead. She'll back it back out. Gets it to Hayden. Hayden works it to Amari Morrison. Puts it high off the glass. No good. And over the back is going to be called on the Lady Colts. That's going to be on Kyler Hardy. Hardy's first personal foul, first team foul against the Lady Colts. Foul comes at 5:31 to play. First quarter, Lady Colts on top, 5-3. Lady Colts basketball being brought to you tonight by McDonald's of Southwest Arkansas. Push out front, no call. India Atkins gets it. They'll work it right corner. Shot on the way inside the arc, no good. And the rebound's going to be pulled down by Morrison. Gets it to Hardy. Hardy ahead to Hayden. Hayden on the run. Bounce pass in the corner. Driving. Samaya Smith put up the running one-hander from 8 feet. Won't go. Rebound. Fought for. Smith or Morrison got it. Shot put up. No good. Underneath. Put back in. Smith. Samaya with her first two. Lady Colts break on top. 7-3. On the other end. Long down court pass. And Amari Morrison's going to be called for the personal foul. Ashley Blaylock beat everybody back to the other end. Morrison had to foul in order to prevent that easy shot as the Blaylock's into the free throw line. First free throw of the night by the Nighthawks, and that one is no good. 7-3, 4:50 to play. First quarter, Lady Colts on top by four. Second shot by Blaylock off the front of the iron. No good, and the rebound comes off to Hayden. Here come the Lady Colts. Last time these two teams got together, Nighthawks had a hard day at the free throw line. Oh, nice. Drive underneath. Reverse shot put up and in by Fuller. She's got three. Lady Colts on top by six. Their biggest lead of the night. And on the other end, Nighthawks got in a hurry and turned it over. And the Lady Colts will check in. Jera Cotton for Amari Morrison. And Kiana Holly also coming into the lineup. And she'll come in for Samaya Smith. So it's Holly, Hardy, Cotton, Hayden, and Fuller in the lineup. Fuller with it, right wing. Cross courts it over to Smith, or actually to Hayden. Carmella Hayden out front to Fuller. Fuller has it tipped away. As a pass inside to Holly was tipped away and then picked up by the Nighthawks. Shot put up by India Atkins, won't go. Rebound comes off to Hayden. Hayden's pass is stolen away by Atkins. She's everywhere. Tries that right side, kicks it back out, three-pointer on the way, no good, rebound. Comes off to Hayden, and traveling's gonna be called on Hayden. Hayden went up, grabbed the rebound, lost her balance, and it's called for the travel. Wound up on her backside. And let's see here. Nighthawks will have it on the baseline. 30 seconds on the shot clock. 3:54 to play first quarter. Deep in that left corner, and I think Fuller's going to be called for the personal foul on the inbounds pass. She is. Kayla's first. So Morrison, Hardy, and Fuller, Lady Colts' three sophomores that were honored before the game tonight, each have one personal foul. Nighthawks, stack inbounds play. Long three-pointer off the front of the iron, no good. And that rebound is going to be tipped around, finally picked up by the Nighthawks. India Atkins has it on the right side outside the circle. They'll work it back left side to Townsend. They'll pull up for the three. No. Rebound. Long rebound comes out to Hardy. Hardy gets it across to Hayden. Hayden in the corner to Fuller. Back out to Holly. Kiana facing some pressure there from Atkins. Cotton fires it back out to Hayden. Her shot no good. The rebound comes off. Big collision out there. Let's see. And that's going to be a blocking foul on Kayla Fuller. Fuller couldn't quite get there in time. She got the worst end of that collision. She hit the floor hard. Tough kid gets right back up. She's going to come out right now, though. Get a breather, and Samaya Smith is going to check back in. Smith, Hayden, Cotton, Hardy, Holly in the lineup. National Park They'll work it around the perimeter. Try to drive inside. They'll kick it back out for three. That three-pointer, no good. Rebound underneath, no good. Partially blocked by Cotton. Picked out of the air by Hayden. Carmella works it right side to Cotton. Big collision out there on that pass. Hardy got the best of that. Comes through, lays it off the glass, and good! Count it! Kyler Hardy fouled in the act of shooting. Count the basket. She's going to the free throw line. Lady Colts up by 8, 11-3. Foul is going to be called against Carnesha Griffin. That's her second. And at the free throw line, that's Kyler Hardy. Sends it on the way. It goes down. Hardy with 3 points. Lady Colts on top, 12-3. 2:50 to play, first quarter. Cross court, Atkins has it. Bounce pass up top of the key. They're working left side. They get it back over into the hands of Atkins. Fires it back out. Three-pointer on the way. No. Air ball. Hauled down by Samaya Smith. Gets it to Hayden, and Carmella will walk it into the front court with 2:25 to play in the first quarter. Lady Colts on top by 9, 12-3. Deep in the corner, that's Cotton. Cotton gets it out to Hayden. Hayden in the corner. Samaya Smith sends it on the way for three. Samaya Smith with a three. She's got five. Lady Colts on top by a dozen, 15-3. Nighthawks have it. They'll get it back out in the hands of Baker. Janaya, shot put up off the glass, won't go. The rebound, Kyler Hardy turns around and says, look what I found. Gives it ahead to Hayden. Hayden wants to run, goes into the lane, lays it up and in. Nice roll that time for Carmella Hayden. Lady Colts 17, National Park 3. A minute 46 to play first quarter. Timeout on the court. We're back in a moment on N88Radio.com.
UA Casa Tot Colts merchandise is now available at the ERCs in Dequeen, Ashdown, and Nashville. Come on in and let our friendly staff show you around. We have a lot to choose from, including t-shirts in a variety of styles and colors, caps, hoodies, polos, long sleeve t-shirts. We have joggers and stuff like coffee mugs and insulated thermal tumblers, as well as flash drives, lanyards, and power bank chargers. Just let the staff know what you need, and who knows, they might even model it for you. Show your Casa Tot school spirit. Get your Colts merchandise today at an ERC near you.
National Park called a timeout as the Lady Colts on a nice run right here. They've railed off 12 straight to lead at 17-3, their biggest lead of the day. Minute 30 to go in this first half, or first quarter, I should say. Three-pointer on the way by Atkins, hard off the glass, no good. And National Park having a hard time from the perimeter. Jump ball's a call on that rebound. And the possession arrow points for the Nighthawks. First time these two teams played in Hot Springs. National Park shot the ball extremely well from the perimeter, and they haven't had quite that much luck here at the Bank of Locksburg Gymnasium, as that shot's an air ball picked up by Samaya Smith ahead to Carmella Hayden. Left side, Kiana Holly fires up the three, won't go. Rebound comes off to Janaya Baker. Baker on the run. Gets in the lane, puts it up. Whistle and a foul. That's going to be on Morrison. I think that's her second. So Amari's picked up her second personal foul. Both she and Kayla Fuller with two. And they're going to say that she was not in the act of shooting. That's the third, fifth team foul against the Lady Colts. And coming out for the Lady Colts will be Morrison. Left side, National Park with it in the corner. Ball tipped out of bounds. I think Kyler Hardy got a hand on it over there. And the Nighthawks will have it. Pass into the backcourt, picked up by the Nighthawks. Checking in the ball game there. That's Katie Pleasance. Into the hands of Baker. Janiyah working out there against Kiana Holly. Lob pass in the corner. 5 seconds on the shot clock. And Janiyah Baker called for the travel. Shot clock was about to expire anyway. Lady Colts get it back on top by 14, 17-3. Carmella Hayden with it. Drives inside the lane, puts it high off the glass, no good. And the rebound is going to be a reaching foul on Hayden. Carmella trying to get that ball back. National Park will be heading to the other end to shoot some free throws here. Fifth team foul against the Lady Colts. 38.1 seconds remaining here in this first quarter. National Park trying to break a 12-point run by the Lady Colts. It's 5-3 at one point. Second shots on the win is good by Jyla Calvin. So Calvin with her first free throw, fourth point of the night. Calvin has all four National Park's points. As a team, they are now 2 out of 4 at the free throw line as that one's up and in. Lady Colts have it. 35 seconds to play, first quarter. Out to Hayden. Hayden outside the circle. Gets it to Holly. Holly wants to go baseline, gets it to Cotton. Cotton bounce pass inside to Hardy. Back outside to Smith for three. In there. Samaya Smith, she's got 8. Lady Colts on top, 20-5. Atkins with it. 10 seconds, first quarter. They'll work it left side to Baker. Janiyah cross-courts it to Atkins. 4 seconds. As Baker takes the long three, no. Rebound. National Park, we've come to the end of the first quarter of play. Our score, Lady Colts 20, National Park 5. We're back in a moment on 888 Radio.
Hey, I didn't order any pizza.
Jake from State Farm. After you saved me so much dough on insurance with that Parker promo, I devised a promo for you.
Here's the deal, Parker. State Farm offers everyone surprisingly great rates.
Yeah, right. Pepperoni pockets, an atomic brownie, cuckoo crusty.
There's no promo, it's just great rates.
And a cider ranch. You're the man, man.
When you want the real deal, like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Your local State Farm insurance agent in DeQueen is Luke Billingsley, 870-642-2157.
Lady Colts basketball on 888radio.com being brought to you by State Farm. Your State Farm insurance agent in DeQueen is Luke Billingsley. Also by Pilgrims, by Coca-Cola of Nashville, and by Dr. Randy Walker. Lady Colts lead it 20-5 after the first quarter. As 5 different Lady Colts have figured in the scoring. Meanwhile, 8 points in that first half for Samaya Smith, including a couple of three-pointers. She leads the Lady Colts with 8. And National Park, on the other hand, Jyla Calvin has all 5 of their first quarter points. As the Lady Colts have it, as we get the second quarter underway. Be Kiana Holly, Samaya Smith, Carmella Hayden, Jera Cotton, and Kyler Hardy in the lineup for the Lady Colts. Hayden backs it out, gets it in the hands of Smith. Smith stops outside the lane, gets it to Cardi. Kyler works inside, tries to get up that little baby hook and can't get it to go, but she's going to be fouled in the act of shooting. It's on Jyla Calvin. Calvin, their leading scorer. She also has 2 personal fouls here in the early going. Into the free throw line will be Kyler Hardy. Hardy, 3 points in the ball game, 1 for 1 at the charity stripe tonight. Kyler, one of the 3 Lady Colts sophomores honored this evening prior to the ball game. Her first free throw is no good. Hardy, Fuller, and Morrison have been a part of a number of victories over the past 2 years here at the Bank of Locksburg Gymnasium. Second shot by Hardy's up and good. Lady Colts take their biggest lead of the night at 16, 21-5. Out front, Atkins. Atkins works it to Baker. Janiyah, bounce pass, left side. Back over to Atkins. She'll fire up the three. No. Rebound, Cotton. Jarrah fires it ahead. Gets it to Holly. Holly chases it down. Wow. Looked like she's about to lose the handle about three times right there. Came up with it. When things are going right, they're going right. Hayden has it. Outside the circle. Gets it to Hardy. Hardy bounce pass. Oh, nice give inside. Looking for Holly. Kiana couldn't quite handle it. Nice pass in traffic, though. And the Lady Colts turn it over. National Park will have it. As Baker gets it over to Atkins. Back over to Janiyah. Baker back over to India Atkins. They'll fire it inside the lane, into the hands of Calvin. Shot put up right side by Atkins, won't go. She is ice cold tonight. Rebound comes off to Hardy. Hardy to Hayden. Hayden down court to Holly. Holly, baseline to Cotton. Cotton went up, couldn't get it to go, got her own rebound. Had that shot blocked, and the rebound comes off to Atkins. Atkins wants to run. It's a one on four. No shot, no good. And on the rebound, Baker's going to be called for the personal foul for a reach in. Janiyah called for the foul. And Samaya Smith's going to come into the lane. And let's see here. Somebody came out. I'm trying to find out who. Who left? I'm missing somebody. Hayden has it. Hayden works around the screen by Hardy, goes in the lane, tries to put it up, and loose ball on the baseline, goes out of bounds, last touched by National Park. Hayden was in there trying to draw a foul. Thought there was going to be one called. Nope. Hayden will make the inbounds pass. Eventually, maybe, as good defense that time by the Nighthawks. Lady Colts have it. Pass inside, goes to Hardy. Works hard in there, can't get it to go in the rebound. It's going to be picked up by National Park. Nighthawks have it. Sydney Townsend cross-courts it deep in that left corner. Driving, shot put up, no good, rebound. Jarrah Cotton in traffic. Gets it out to Hayden, has the ball stripped away. Atkins pulls up free throw line, puts it up and in. India Atkins gets her first two of the night. Makes it 21-7. Lady Colts had reeled off 16 straight points before that basket. Shot put up and in by the Lady Colts. In the corner, three-pointer on the way, won't go. We've got a whistle. On the rebound attempt, personal foul is going to be called against Kamaya Beal. And scratch that 16-point run, okay? Forgot about a couple of points they made earlier. Still an impressive run by the Lady Colts. More like a 16-2 run there before that last basket. Hardy inside the lane, goes up strong, puts it up and in. Kyler with a basket. She's got six. Lady Colts on top by 18, 25-7. Bounce pass, left side, corner. Lady Colts getting after it defensively in the corner. And let's see. Timeout. Called by National Park. Our score, Lady Colts 25, National Park 7. Back in a moment on N88Radio.com.
It's in the smallest details. The answer. How is Husqvarna chainsaw durable and at the same time lightweight? And how can an XP chainsaw from Husqvarna help you work both faster and safer? It's in all those small engineered details. Husqvarna, ready when you are.
I had to run down the scorer's table for just a moment because I'd missed a basket a moment ago. And I'd said a moment ago that Kyler had six. She actually has eight. She's had back-to-back baskets. Lady Colts on top, 25-7. as National Park after the timeout. It's India Atkins putting it off the glass and good. Atkins has four, and the Lady Colts lead 25-9. 6.5 minutes to play first half. Bounce pass, free throw line. Morrison at inside the lane, can't get the shot to go. Rebound tipped up. Jared Cotton tipped it three times, got it to come down, put it up in the hands of Hayden. Hayden puts it up and in. Hayden gets the basket. Give Cotton the assist. The rebound and the assist. Lady Colts back on top, 27-9. Three-pointer on the way, no. Rebound. That's going to be Hayden in traffic. Comes out of there with it. Lady Colts will set the offense with 6 minutes to play in the first half. On top, 27-9. Bounce pass, free throw line. Nice defense that time by Townsend. Got the passing lane, came the other way, laid it up and in. Townsend with her first two of the night. Nighthawks trail at 27-11. Into the front court. That's Carmella Hayden. Hayden works around the screen by Morrison, goes baseline, has a shot blocked out of bounds by Townsend. Nice block by Townsend. Lady Colts will get it on the baseline. They lead at 27-11 with 5:36 to play in this first half. Winner of this game moves on. They'll take on SAU Tech on Saturday. As India Atkins comes the other way, lays it up, no good. Rebound, oh, tough rebound that time by National Park. Shot would not go, however, by Calvin. And looks like Jared Cotton's going to come out. Kayla Fuller's back in. So it's Fuller along with Holly Morrison, Samaya Smith, and Carmella Hayden. Actually, Hayden Smith is coming out. And okay, Smith is going to stay in, and Cotton's going to go back in a moment. A little confusion there on the bench. Inbounds pass in the hands of Townsend, puts it right up and in. She's got four. Lady Colts up by 14, 27-13. Fuller with it, gets it out front to Hayden. Hayden drives inside. Like to get it inside to Morrison if she could, but Morrison's kind of covered over there. Fuller has it. She'll fire it up just inside the free throw circle. Hits the front of the rim, rolls over the top, and falls in there. Nice touch that time. She's got five. Lady Colts on top, 29-13. Left side shot, no good. Rebounds pulled down by Hayden. Carmella has it in the backcourt. Just under 5 minutes to play, first half. Hayden gets it out to Fuller. Now they'll get it to Holly. Big collision out there. Fuller hit the court. And the rebound's going to be pulled down by Townsend. Sydney has it. She'll jog it into the front court. Cross away. Looking for Atkins. Atkins attacks. Pulls up from eight. Can't get it to go. The rebound by Kiana Holly. Holly over to Hayden. Here come the Lady Colts with 4:15 to play. First half. Holly will get control of the offense here to Fuller. Fuller wants to drive, gets inside the lane. Working in there, puts it off the glass, can't get it to go. She's going to be called for the travel. Took an extra step down low. Good defense that time on the part of Katie Pleasants. Lady Colts will turn it over. Leading by a score of 29-13. 4 minutes to play in this first half as Indy Atkins bounce pass. Down on the baseline, Pleasant saw a nice give that time. They just couldn't finish. Rebound comes off to Hayden. Hayden to Fuller. Fuller in the lane, reaching foul. That may be on Atkins. They're going to get the one in front or the one in the back. That's on Atkins. So Atkins called for her first personal foul. It'll be the fourth foul, team foul against the Nighthawks. Deep in that left corner, right corner, that's Fuller. Fuller gets it out to Hayden. Hayden has it stripped away. Loose ball picked up by the Nighthawks. Coming the other way, Atkins. Caught it on the wrong foot, had to take an extra step, and is going to be called for the travel. Nighthawks had a shot at an easy basket right there. Lady Colts have it. 3:20 to play, first half. Hayden works around the double screen. Atkins on the ball. Hayden gets it out to Cotton. Cotton wants to drive. Oh, nice bounce pass right side. Fuller pulls up from 14. No good. There's Holly with a rebound. Gets it inside to Cotton. Cotton's going to try to fire it out. Steal by India Atkins. Nice defense that time. This time she goes all the way, lays it up and in. Atkins with 6 points in the ball game. Takes over scoring honors for the Nighthawks. Lady Colts on top by 14, 29-15, and we've got a timeout on the court. Our score, Lady Colts 29, National Park 15. Back after this from McDonald. Coach Satana, some new one to talk to the Lady Colts. Got a little sloppy on a couple of possessions right there. One settling back down on top, 29-15. This game is far from over, but 2:45 to play in this first half. Free throw line, Morrison gets in the corner to Holly. Over to Fuller, back left side to Samaya Smith for three. Can't get it to go. That rebound's tipped out of bounds. Last touch by the Lady Colts. Wait a minute. They're actually going to say that's a foul on Hardy. Kyler Hardy's going to be called for a second personal foul. So Hardy, Morrison, and Fuller each with two. When you've only got seven people on your roster, now apparently, do we have a technical foul called here? Officials are talking about it here. Let's see. Well, actually, that's going to be the third on Hardy. At the free throw line is Townsend. She missed that first one. She'll have another one coming here. That shot's on the way. It's off. No good. National Park only 2 out of 6 at the free throw line thus far tonight. Nighthawks will have it across the way. Down by 14 with 2.5 to play in this first half. Bounce pass. Double team up top. Townsend has it. Gets it back out. Three-pointer on the way. Catch and shoot. Won't go. Rebound. Holly off her fingertips out of bounds. National Park will get it back with a fresh 20 on that clock. They'll work it left side. Looking underneath. Atkins puts it up. No good. Rebound comes off to Hardy. Kyler gets it ahead to Samaya Smith. Smith on the attack. Bounce pass. Kicked around. Picked up by Fuller. Fuller stayed with it. Ball was being knocked around like a pinball out there. Lady Colts. Shot no good. Rebound. Atkins saves it in. Jared Cotton there on the court. And the ball goes out of bounds. Last touch by Cotton. National Park will get it back here. Right side, Townsend outside the arc, fires it back left side to Atkins. Atkins in the corner to Pleasants, her pass into the backcourt. Fuller chases it down, goes all the way, lays it up and in. Kayla Fuller. She's got 7, Lady Colts on top, 31-15. A minute 20 to play. First half. National Park. India Atkins has it. Out to Townsend. Free throw line. Calvin goes in and a whistle and a foul. That's going to be on Holly. Kiana called for the personal foul. That'll be her first. And National Park will be at the free throw line as Jyla Calvin heads to the free throw line. She's 2 for 2 at the charity stripe tonight, 5 points in the ball game. Those two free throws going along with a three-pointer back in that first quarter. As a matter of fact, she had all the points for National Park in that first quarter. So her first free throw is no good. Score stays at 31-15 with 1:09 to play, first half. Cotton, Smith, Hardy, Fuller, and Holly in the lineup as a second shot for Calvin is good. Lady Colts have it on top, 31-16. Up top, that's Hardy. Hardy works it right corner. Fuller brings it back out, gets it in the hands of Kiana Holly. Out to Fuller. Bounce pass, free throw line to Hardy. In traffic, goes up strong to the basket, and she's going to be fouled. Personal foul is going to be called against Sydney Townsend. That's her first. Head to the free throw line will be Kyler Hardy. Hardy, 2 out of 3 at the free throw line tonight. She's got 8 points in the ball game. That one is on the way, and it's good. Hardy can hit double figures if she knocks this one down. Sophomore out of Murphy, Texas, has given us a lot of highlights over the past 2 years. Kyler's second shot's on the way, and it's off, no good. The rebound's going to be chased down by Townsend. Lady Colts on top, 32-16, with 40 seconds to go in this first half. Right side, Atkins tries to attack, lost it momentarily. 15 seconds on the shot clock. Right side, Atkins will fire up a long three. No, rebound comes off to Pleasance. Another long three on the way, in there. Shot put up and in by Jyla Calvin. It's her second three of the night. Three-pointer on the way by Kiana Holly, won't go. And the rebound comes off to National Park. 8 seconds to go, first half. Pass down low, Townsend fires it out to Pleasance. Drives inside the circle, can't get it to go. Rebound, Pleasance at the buzzer, high off the glass, no good. And we've come to the end of the first half of play. Our score, Lady Colts 32, National Park 19. We're back in a moment here on N88Radio.com.
Look at where we are. Think of what we can do. What we're building together is special. And at Southwestern Electric Power Company, we know it's only the beginning. We can do more to improve our communities, our lives. We can reimagine how we use power and where that power comes from. We believe every person, no matter how unique, makes us stronger. By working together, the energy to accomplish our dreams is boundless.
Well, it's easy to do that. It really is. Well, at the end of the first half, Lady Colts lead it by a score of 32-19. Lady Colts led 5-3. And then went on an 11-point run. Is that right? I think it was a 12-point run. Yeah, they went on a 12-point run and wound up finishing the first quarter up by a score of 20-5 and lead at the half 32-19 as Lady Colts are being led at the half by Kyler Hardy. She's got 9 points, but she also has 3 fouls. 7 points in the first half for Kayla Fuller. Also scoring in that first half, 8 points in the first half for Samaya Smith, including a couple of three-pointers, 4 points each for Carmella Hayden and Amari Morrison. Meanwhile, Nighthawks are a bit led at the half by Jyla Calvin. She's got 9 points, including a couple of three-pointers, 6 points for India Atkins and 4 points for Sydney Townsend. Again, our score at the half. Lady Colts lead it by a score of 32-19, and we'll be back in a moment on N88Radio.com.
This live stream broadcast on N88 is made possible by Satellite Service Company in Nashville, your authorized Dish Network dealer. Satellite Service Company and Dish Network serve the entertainment needs of the entire area. You like sports? Dish Network sports packages offer every sports fan exciting action featuring your favorite teams. The Dish Tailgater portable satellite TV antenna lets you watch TV wherever you are, at the lake, in the mountains, or at the tailgate party outside the stadium. The Dish Hopper gives you the power to transform your computer, smartphone, or tablet into your TV and enjoy your home TV anywhere. Special discounts and packages available to fit any budget. Satellite Service Company, 301 South Main Street in Nashville.
Migrated from Mexico to the United States when I was 6.5 years old. I think I turned 7 here. I still remember the day that I came in on a Friday. My dad had everything squared out. Like, he had it all planned out. We went to church that Sunday. It was all English. I had no idea what the priest was talking about. But because I'm Catholic, I know the routines and everything. So I was able to do some of that stuff. And then Monday, here we go to a school. In Mexico, I went to school with my siblings from 1 p.m. to 6 p.m. And then we walked to our school. We carried our little lunch bag, and then we come to a school where we have to get up early. I have to go in this big yellow bus, which I was afraid of. Not only that, but I get car sick, so you can imagine. I struggled for quite a bit. And then you come to a school where you can't communicate with your teachers, you can't communicate with your friends. At that time, the Hispanics that were at the week schools at that time were on the same boat that I was. We really couldn't help each other on the translating or interpreting because they were either just 1 year ahead of me at the school or just got in like me. So I do remember myself sleeping through the classroom. The only thing I knew to do was math, which I think that's universal. Numbers translate to all languages, I think. So I was able to do math. Other than that, I think I slept through the whole thing because poor teachers, they didn't know how to go about helping me or me communicating with them. So, it was a struggle. It was very different, culture shocking. I learned that we get breakfast in the morning and then we get lunch and then we get to go home. So I wasn't used to that. I was used to carrying my own lunch, whatever I like. And now I'm having to eat this different food, different taste. And it was some difficult times. I could not mingle with my classmates as much because of the language barrier. Once again, we couldn't communicate. So I remember sitting myself back on a bench or somewhere in a corner, just watching everybody do their thing. And here I am crying because I was crying. I was separated from my siblings. They all went to different classrooms, different buildings. And then here I am by myself. And so I felt really, really bad. But in the long run, here I am. I'm a teacher now, and I'm in the ESL program position. So how I wanted to be a teacher, or how I got to this place, is I think to be somebody, you, in my opinion anyway, you are born with something. And in my situation, I feel I was born to be a teacher. Whether it was in Mexico or here or anywhere, I think I was born to be a teacher. I was born to help others. And since I was little and I can remember, everything and all I did was related to education. So I worked really, really hard in understanding the language. Once again, back in the day, there weren't a lot of resources for the Hispanic kids like me. I had to really learn a lot of stuff, and I don't think teachers, colleges knew exactly how to go about with students like me on helping them find what they needed. So I had to do a lot of research and asking around, and I don't think Googling at that time. I don't remember if we had Googled at that time. Probably did. I'm not that old though. But just the struggle to be where I'm at was not an easy path, but I have always said that easy is not always the best. If you struggled, you value more your struggle, your path. And I think I'm at that point. My path to where I'm at right now was not as easy, but I know it's not as hard as others. But thanks to all that, I am where I'm at. Thanks to my parents that brought me here. At that time, when I was 6.5 years old, I did not understand why I had to leave everything behind, family, home, everything, school, everything, and come to a place where I had no idea what it was about. To me, it was like moving from Earth to another planet. So I resented my parents for a good long 4 years, I think, because I felt they brought me without asking, without giving us a heads up of what's going to happen. Or if they did, I was so little, I do not remember. But now I thank them. I thank them for what they did, because now at my hometown is probably not the best place to be right now because of all the stuff going around. But I feel safe in this country. I feel free and I feel independent. All the struggles that I went through are worth it because now I can value all that struggle and do what I want to do, which is to be a teacher, to work with kids, to work with the community. Now I am bilingual and I can use those skills to help others. Kids, adults, whoever needs me, I'm there to help. So I value all of that stuff. And once again, how I got here, I think I always wanted to be a teacher and I worked hard for that. It wasn't easy, but if you have perseverance, if you work hard for what you want, you can always do it. So all you have to do is dream it, work for it, and then you can make it. Language barrier is not a problem, no more. If you make that as an excuse, I'm gonna say no, language barrier is not a problem. It's all in your head, it's all in your heart, is what you want for yourself. So if you want to succeed in life and you want to succeed in a good way, work hard, because things are not going to be placed in front of you and make it easy. They're going to be hard, and the hard path is always the best. The easy path, probably not.
I'm Barbara Dixon, and this is Anna Belcher, and we're with Southern Bancorp Bank. Southern is a different kind of bank. We are a designated community development financial institution, and our main focus, our mission, is to be involved in and serve the community. And what makes us different is we offer traditional banking services, but we also offer other services that help strengthen our community, to teach them financial literacy and to help them to build credit, understand credit, and to make good, wise choices. Some of the programs we offer, we have a learning center that covers everything from savings to loans to small business, housing. There's also a section of that website that is designated for youth that's broken up by age groups, so you can get financial literacy information for your children on that website. There's a section for senior citizens as well. We also offer free credit review. We will help you pull your free credit report, go over it with you, give you the resources to review it and to know what to look for. We offer a credit builder CD loan to help you start building credit history or to improve your credit history. We also offer free counseling services, whether you want to just do a budget or just ask questions. That service is free and it's all free to customers and non-customers alike. We offer free home ownership counseling services. We offer free income tax preparation through the VITA program. It's a voluntary income tax preparation assistance program. And for consumers who qualify, we prepare their taxes free. We will be doing that right here in the Locksburg branch. A lot of what Southern does is they try to strengthen the community, the businesses and individuals alike. And we are considered, one of our models is to be wealth builders for everyone. And one of the primary ways we start that is by teaching savings habits. And Anna is going to tell you a little bit about some of those.
We have a few savings products that's going on right now. One is our Roundup Savings. Every time you use your debit card, you can either round up to the next dollar amount, or you can round up a certain dollar, whether it's one or five, just whatever is convenient for you. And we also have what is called an app that you can download, and the app is called Envy. And it is a savings game. It's 100 days process, and you determine how much you want to save in 100 days. And every day that you go into the app, you open the envelope, and it may transfer a dollar, it may transfer $2. Whatever is in that envelope on that app that day is how much it transferred to your savings account. We also have what we call a CD credit builder loan. If you are just starting out and getting credit, or you've just graduated from school and you're having a hard time getting credit because you have no credit score, or even if you've had past negative credit, then you can come in and we can start you out with credit of a CD loan, and that also gives you a CD. When you pay your loan off, that CD is your money. And Southern believes in Sevier County. We believe in empowering our community, and we are thankful to be here in Sevier County, and we look forward to serving Sevier County and the people in this community for years to come.
Well, we're set to get underway as Lady Colts lead National Park as we start this second half. Mikayla Fuller, along with Samaya Smith, Amari Morrison, Kyler Hardy, and Carmella Hayden in the lineup for the Lady Colts. Townsend with it on the perimeter for the Nighthawks. They'll work it back right side. India Atkins, bounce pass in the corner. Give inside, back out to Atkins. They'll fire it out to Townsend. Townsend tries to attack, lays it up inside. Can't get the one-hander to go, and the rebound goes out of bounds off the fingertips of Cornisha Griffin. Lady Colts get it back. They're going to face some full court pressure right here. They get it ahead to Hardy. Hardy gets it over to Fuller. Fuller fires it ahead at the free throw line. That's Hardy. Goes in the lane, lays it up. Had a collision. Scooped it up with one hand, knocked it down. Excuse me. She's got 11. And the Lady Colts lead it 34-19. Atkins will fire up the three, in and out, no good, and Hardy chases down the rebound. Kyler runs it into the front court. Working out there, and working left side. Smith shakes the defender, pulls up from 16, rattles it around, and it's in there. Samaya Smith with a basket. She's got 10 points in the ball game. Lady Colts with a couple of players in double figures now. Bounce pass up top. Townsend takes a long three-pointer. That's an air ball out of bounds. National Park shot a lot of threes in that first half, made a couple of them. And they start out not so hot in the second half. It's Hayden, or Smith rather, gives it to Hayden. Hayden double-teamed up top. Carmella back it out. Atkins comes out there, puts a little bit of pressure in that direction. Nice screen set up by Smith. Hayden's shot no good, and the rebound is going to be pulled down by National Park. They'll run it the other way in the corner. Shot put up inside the lane. Tough shot, won't go. And the rebound comes off to Hayden. Carmella gets it across the timeline. Left side, Smith will fire up the long three. No good. That rebound's picked up by Atkins. Atkins wants to run the other way. Goes through the lane. Bump on the layup attempt, no call. Shot goes in. And Atkins now with 8 points in the ball game. Lady Colts on top, 36-21 inside the lane. Reverse layup. Kayla Fuller, she's got 9. Lady Colts on top by 17, 38-21. National Park works it left side out on the wing. Out front to Townsend. Townsend to Atkins, India. Looks inside. Get it back into the hands of Calvin. Underneath, three-pointer on the way. Won't go. Rebound up and in. Whistle and a foul. That's going to be on Hardy. That's going to be her fourth. Heading to the free throw line will be Ashley Blaylock. Blaylock with her first points of the night, and Hardy's picked up her fourth personal foul. Oh, actually, they're going to say that's her third. Okay. At the free throw line, that'll be Blaylock. She's 0 for 2 at the free throw line tonight. That one's up and in. She's got 3 points in the ball game. Lady Colts lead it 38-22. Left side. They'll work it. Oh, they haven't added the I think that score looks better now. 38-24. It was off by a couple of points there. To the Lady Colts' favor, that is. In the corner, Fuller fires it up just outside the three-point circle. Can't get it to go. Atkins is there for the rebound. India on the run. At the free throw line, shot on the way up and in. Atkins, she's in double figures with 10. Four of them here in this third quarter. Lady Colts up by a dozen. Right side in the corner. Three-pointer on the way. In there. Kayla Fuller hits her first three of the night. She's got a dozen points. Lady Colts on top, 41-26. Ball stolen away by Hardy. Kyler going all the way with it. Lays it up. Can't get it to go. Rebound comes off to Fuller. Bounce pass to Morrison. High off the glass and good. Amari Morrison has six. Lady Colts on top now by a score of 43-26. Other end, shot put up. One-hander good. And let's see here. Personal foul, basket that time. Lady Colts have a player down on the far end. That's Morrison. She never did get up after that basket a moment ago. Blaylock knocked down the basket just then. She's got five. But Morrison, Coach Mark Moore is out there to help her off the court. She came down rather awkwardly on that basket a moment ago. And she's trying to shake it off on that right leg. She'd certainly had a high ankle sprain prior to the Christmas break. She's trying to shake this one off, but man, she's in some pain right now. Amari comes out of the lineup. And checking in her place will be Jira Cotton. So it's Cotton, Hayden, Smith, Hardy, and Fuller in the lineup. Lady Colts with only seven players on the roster. And Morrison is a big part of what the Lady Colts do. Left side, Cotton has it. Out on the wing, bounce pass back out front to Hayden. Hayden works it left side to Fuller, back out to Hayden. Back to Fuller. 12 seconds on the shot clock. Back over to Hayden. Facing Atkins in the corner. Back out to Hayden. She'll fire up the three. That will not go. Hardy there for the rebound. Gets it to Fuller, and Fuller resets it. Let's see. Apparently something came out of the stands. We stopped the play for just a moment here. Officials talking it over. So they'll run the clock down to 8 seconds on the shot clock, I believe. And the Lady Colts will put the ball in play underneath their own basket. National Park bench wanting a clarification right here. 5 seconds on the shot clock. So Lady Colts make the inbounds pass, but they're going to have to work for a quick shot here with 5:41 to play here in this third quarter. Up by 15, 43-28. And let's see here. Kiana Holly's going to come in. Kayla Fuller will check out. So Holly will trigger the inbounds pass. Lady Colts. Long pass out to Smith in traffic. Fires it high off the glass. No good. Townsend grabs the rebound, and Sydney brings it the other way. Ball stolen away, however, by Hayden. Hayden runs it into the front court. She'll back it back out, gets it to Smith. Out to Hayden, left side. Smith underneath looking for Cotton. Ball tipped out of bounds, last touch by the Nighthawks. 21 seconds on the shot clock here. 5:22 to play in this third quarter. Lady Colts on top, 43-28. Long pass out front, goes to Holly. Holly to Smith, over to Hayden for three. Carmella's three-pointer won't go, and that rebound's going to be pulled down by Ashley Blaylock. Blaylock gets it ahead to India Atkins. Fires it left side. Double team in the corner. They'll get it back out to Townsend. Sydney fires it back left side. Three-pointer on the way. No good. Rebound. Tipped out of bounds by Cotton. Cotton battling for that rebound down low. And the ball goes out of bounds. Last touch by the Lady Colts with 4:57 to go in this third quarter. National Park, three-pointer off the inbounds pass. Off the glass and good by India Atkins. Atkins has 13. Lady Colts up by a dozen, 43-31. And Coach Stan wants a timeout. 4:46 to play third quarter. Lady Colts on top by 12. We're back in a moment here on Ed88 Radio. I lost my mind in the city of life. And the bad street bends in the neon light. When I heard the thunder, I could feel the rain. It's the same to me, just different name. Lady Colts have the basketball after that timeout. They'll work it deep in the corner. Kiana Holly out to Hayden. Back to Kiana. Over to Carmella at top of the key. Works it out on that left wing to Samaya Smith. Smith inside it goes to Hardy. Hardy back out in the corner to Smith. Running 12-footer on the baseline. Won't go, and the rebound's going to be pulled down by Griffin. Loose ball picked up by the Lady Colts, however. Tipped around and now picked up by National Park. Down by 12 with 4:10 to play in this third quarter. Sydney Townsend with it in the corner. And a charging foul going to be called against Ashley Blaylock. That's her first. And taking that charge was Carmella Hayden. Lady Colts will have it on the far end. 4:07 to play in this third quarter. Hayden will jog it into the front court. Gets it up top to Hardy, left side to Holly. Bounce pass out front to Smith. Smith gets it inside to Hardy. Had to fight for that basketball. In traffic, whistle foul, and she's going to the free throw line. Personal foul is going to be called against Sydney Townsend. That's her second. Hardy will go to the free throw line to shoot a pair. She's two, make that three out of five at the free throw line tonight. She's got 11 points in the game. Shots on the way, no good. Kyler will have another one coming here. Lady Colts on top by a dozen, 43-31. 3:52 to go in this one, in this third quarter. Second shot is in there. Hardy now with a dozen points. Lady Colts up by lucky 13, 44-31. Sydney Townsend with it at the free throw line. Townsend's going to fire up a long three. No. Rebound. Atkins tipped it as Hardy had it. And a whistle and a foul from behind will be called on Ashley Blaylock. That's her second. Lady Colts will have it at the far end. 3:37 to go in this third quarter. Lady Colts on top, 44-31. Hayden has it up top. Gives it left side to Smith. Right back to Hayden again. 20 seconds on the shot clock. Bounce pass in the corner to Holly. Back out to Hayden. She'll fire up the quick three, can't get it to go. That rebound comes off in the hands of Ashley Blaylock. Blaylock, a one-on-three, goes inside, got the shot to go, and she's going to the free throw line. Personal foul is going to be on Carmella Hayden. That's her second. And Ashley Blaylock heads to the free throw line, looking for her second three-point play of the night. She's one out of three at the free throw line with 7 points in the ballgame. Holly's going to come out of the lineup. Kiana checks out. Kayla Fuller's back in there. 7 points tonight for Ashley Blaylock. Sends it on the way, and it's good. Blaylock, after missing her first two free throw attempts of the night, has made her second two. Lady Colts lead is cut to 10. As Cotton has it, bounce pass right side, three-pointer on the way by Fuller's in there. Kayla Fuller, her second three of the second half. She's got 15 points in the ball game. National Park with it in the corner. Back out to Atkins. Inside, they'll work it. Ball's tipped away by Cotton. Picked up by Smith. Back to Cotton. Lady Colts come away with a turnover. 47-34. Lady Colts on top. 2.5 minutes to play in this third quarter. Hayden works it left side to Smith. Back out to Hayden. To Smith. Smith in the corner to Fuller. 12 seconds on the shot clock. Hardy has it inside, has the ball tipped away from behind, out of bounds. 9 seconds on the shot clock. Lady Colts will have it underneath their own basket. Leading 47-34, 2:26 to go in this third quarter. Long inbounds pass in the corner. That's Carmella Hayden. Her shot rattles off, no good. Rebound, Fuller in the lane. Can't get that one to go, and the rebound comes off to Atkins. India on the run. Fires it left side, three-pointer on the way. Off the glass and good, high off the glass. What an angle on that. Calvin hits her third three-pointer tonight. It's a 10-point lead for the Lady Colts. They've had a double-digit lead since that first quarter. Fuller puts it up in traffic, can't get it to go, and the rebound comes off to National Park with an opportunity to cut it to single digits. Personal foul on Kayla Fuller on the other end. Fuller's been called for her third personal foul. Kyler Hardy also with three for the Lady Colts. That's the third team foul against the Lady Colts this quarter. National Park will put it in play, down by 10 with 1:50 to play in this third quarter. In the corner, they'll work it up top to Townsend. Tries to attack, fires it out to Atkins for three. Her three-pointer's on the way, good. India Atkins. She's got 10 points this second half, 16 points in the ball game. And the Lady Colts lead down to 7, led by as many as 18. Hardy in traffic goes up, can't get the shot off. Loose ball picked up by Fuller. She's going to be fouled in the act of shooting. That's going to be on Atkins. Atkins call for her second. And at the free throw line will be Kayla Fuller. Fuller, 1-for-2 at the free throw line tonight. 15 points in the ball game. 8 of them here in this second half. Shots on the way, in and out, no good. Sophomore out of Princeton, Texas. We'll have another one coming here. Lady Colts on top, 47-40, with 1:22 to play in the third quarter. Second shot, good. Shot put up underneath, won't go in the rebound. Samaya Smith grabs it. She'll bring it the other way. Gets it off to Hayden. Underneath, shot put up by Fuller. Will not go. Rebound to Atkins. Atkins wants to run. It's a 1-on-5. Lays it up and good. India Atkins doesn't need numbers. That's her 12th point of this second half. Lady Colts lead down to 6. 48-42, as Samaya Smith running 14-footers up and in. Smith with a basket. She's got 13. Out front, 30 seconds to play, third quarter. National Park drives, puts it up, no good. Air ball, Smith gets it to Hayden, gets it to Hardy, back to Hayden. Lady Colts will have it, shot clock is off. 15 seconds to go in this third quarter. Lady Colts on top by 8, 50-42. Hayden has it. Lob pass, free throw line. Hardy gets it in the corner. To Jared Cotton, takes it strong to the basket, puts it up too far under, couldn't get it to go. Rebound goes out of bounds. Last touch by National Park with 0.6 seconds to go in this third quarter. And let's see. Looks like Amari Morrison's going to check in. They'll get it in to Smith. Samaya's shot at the buzzer, no good. We've come to the end of the third quarter of play. Our score, Lady Colts 50, National Park 42. We're back in a moment on Ed88 Radio.
Sweetie, and this is my McDonald's order. I get a Big Mac, Chicken McNuggets, fries, and a Sprite with sweet and sour and barbecue sauce. But I like to mix it all up.
So I'm gonna put some fries on my Big Mac. Or top my fries
with Chicken McNuggets.
That's right.
Or make a totally new sandwich like this. As long as you're doing you, you're doing the sweetie, man. Order ahead on the McDonald's app.
Lady Colts basketball on Ed88Radio.com being brought to you tonight by McDonald's, by Coca-Cola, by Simple Simon's Pizza, and by Dr. Randy Walker, also by Husqvarna. As the Lady Colts lead it 50-42 as we start this fourth quarter. National Park has cut that lead that was 18 at one point, had it down to 7 just a moment ago, stands at 8 as we get set to start this fourth quarter. Lady Colts will have Kayla Fuller, Carmella Hayden, Amari Morrison, Samaya Smith, and Jarrett Cotton in the lineup. 10 minutes to go. One of these teams only has 10 minutes left in their season. The other one will have a tough, tough job on Saturday heading down to East Camden to take on SAU Tech. Lady Colts have it left side. They'll get it in the hands of Smith. Smith in the corner, fires it up for 3, no good, rebound. National Park coming down with, that's Jyla Calvin. Calvin fires it ahead to Atkins. Atkins goes in the lane, one-hander won't go. Rebound comes off to Smith, in traffic, gets out of there with it. They'll get it ahead to Fuller. Fuller wants to attack the baseline, drives all the way through, into the hands of Smith, out to Fuller. Fuller gives it to Hayden, 16 on the shot clock. Left side, up top now. That's right side to Fuller. Fuller will take the 3. In and out, no good. As Jarrett Cotton's shot wouldn't go. Rebound by Smith, no good. Gets her own rebound. Going to be tied up underneath. And the possession arrow points to National Park. Lady Colts up by 8. National Park quickly tried to catch him off guard. Shot up inside, won't go. And the rebound comes off to Morrison. Morrison working on a really bad left ankle right now. Gutting it out tonight. Left side. Lady Colts. As Hayden lost the handle on the ball. Picking it up. Coming the other way. That's Calvin. Jyla puts it up inside the lane. She's going to be fouled. That's going to be on Hayden. That's her third. And heading to the free throw line will be Jyla Calvin. Calvin. She got a dozen points in the ball game, 3 out of 4 at the free throw line tonight. Also hit 3 three-pointers. Calvin, she'll be shooting a couple here as that one's on the way, and it's good. Calvin now with 13 points. Lady Colts lead down to 7, 50-43. Second shot, good. It's a 6-point lead for the Lady Colts, 50-44. Lady Colts have it up top. That's Hayden. Works it left side to Smith. Smith off the dribble. Tries to go up. Jump ball is a call. So Lady Colts will have it. Possession arrow points to UA Casatot. They'll put it in play on the baseline. As the inbounds pass goes out front to Hayden. Over to Smith in the corner to Fuller for 3. That one in and out and in. Fuller banked it in. That's her third three-pointer of the second half. She's got 17 points in the ball game, 10 of them here in the second half. Three-pointer on the way, won't go. Jarrett Cotton gets a rebound. Breaks out into the open. Has the ball stolen away by National Park, coming the other way. Ball tipped, picked up by India Atkins. And you know she's going to make that shot. She's got 20 points on the night, 14 of them here in the second half. Lady Colts lead down to 7, 43-46. They'll work it. Out to Hayden, right side. Morrison gets it in the corner. Back to Morrison, works underneath, can't get the shot to go. Got her own rebound. gives it to Cotton. Cotton lays it off the glass and good. Jarrah, her first two of the night, comes at a really good time. Give Morrison the assist. Lady Colts on top, 55-46. 7.5 to go in this game. Townsend for three. Rebound goes out of bounds. Last touch by the Lady Colts. Forty-six. Lady Colts on top by 9. 7:19 to go in the game. Baseline shot put up by Atkins will not go. Going for the rebound, she knocks it out of bounds. Atkins plays hard. I don't know what she does all the other games, but she plays hard against the Lady Colts. I know that. Lady Colts have it. Up top, they'll get it to Smith. Smith works it out to Fuller. Fuller, left side, right side that is. Back to Fuller in the corner for three. Snuggle that one in there too. Her 4-3 of the second half, Lady Colts on top by a dozen. 58-46. Thank you, Kayla Fuller. India Atkins works it right side to Townsend. Townsend back to Atkins. Lady Colts get some pressure on Atkins here. Three-pointer on the way. Off the back of the iron, Jarrah Cotton chases down the rebound. In the backcourt, needs some help. Gets it to Smith. Fires it ahead to Fuller. Fuller over to Hayden. And the Lady Colts will set the offense with 6:20 to go in the game. On top, 58-46. Hayden has it in the corner. Off the dribble, gets it out to Smith. Right side to Fuller in the corner. Back out to Fuller. 3 seconds on the shot clock. In the corner, they need to shoot. Shot on the way, off, no good. Rebound comes off to Hayden. And the ball goes out of bounds. They're gonna say it was last touch by Hayden. They're gonna talk it over. I think the official, one of the officials said it came off of National Park, or said it came off of UA Cossetot. And I think it actually came off of National Park, and it did. So the Lady Colts will have it in the corner. Thought National Park might have got away with that one right there. They can't get every call right. Now I'm on the other side of the court right here, but look that way to me, and I'm not the least bit biased, right? 6:02 to go in the game. Lady Colts lead it, 58-46. Back in a moment here on NADARadio.com.
In the city of light, and the bad street bangs and the neon lights. When I heard the thunder, I could feel the rain. As it sounded to me, just a different name.
Well, after the timeout, Lady Colts will have it across the way. After the officials had decided wanted to take an extra talk about that, Lady Colts will have an inbounds pass. Smith out to Hayden. Hayden working over there on the left wing. Gets it back out to Smith. 13 seconds on the shot clock. Fuller will fire up another three. And she nailed it. She's had 5 threes, all of them here in the second half. 18 points in this second half, 25 points in the ball game. Lady Colts on top, 61-48. Underneath, shot put up and in. Lady Colts have it on top, 61-48. They'll get it out to Fuller at the free throw line. Shot, or the ball stripped away by Blaylock. Ashley on the run, takes it all the way. Shot put up and in. Blaylock with a basket. I've got her with, what, a dozen points in the ball game. Lady Colts lead down to 11, 61-50 with 5:05 to go. A lot of time left to go in this game. Hayden gets it in the corner. Now they'll dump it down low to Cotton. Puts it high off the glass, no good. And that rebound goes out of bounds. And they're going to say it went off of National Park. Lady Colts will have it on the baseline. 20 seconds on the shot clock. 4:53 to go in the game. Lady Colts on top by 11. Pass goes to Hayden. Hayden working out there in that left corner. Comes out of there with it. She's hard to corral. Backs it out to the horsey head. At the free throw line, pass a little too tall for Morrison. Morrison working on that ankle, can't get quite as high as she did at the start of this game. 4.5 minutes to go in the game. Baseline, Atkins, gonna be called for the travel. So India turns it over and Lady Colts get it back. Looks like Amari Morrison's gonna come out, get a breather. And Kyler Hardy will check in. 4:31 to play in the game. Lady Colts on top by 11, 61-50. National Park hanging around here. Samaya Smith has it out on that left side. Needs a little bit of help over there. Gets in the corner. Down low to Jericotten. Back out it goes to Hayden. 15 seconds on the shot clock. Back to Hayden. Hayden fights off the defender to Cotton. Cotton is going to be fouled. Reaching foul on Atkins. That's going to be Atkins' third personal foul. Head to the free throw line. Or no, they will not be heading to the free throw line. She was not fouled in the act of shooting. And Fuller will trigger the inbounds pass. Gets it into Cotton, right back over to Fuller. Fuller back to Cotton. Cotton fires it back out. Three-pointer on the way by Smith. That one will not go, and the rebound's pulled down by National Park. Griffin gets it ahead. Atkins goes in. Going to be fouled by Carmella Hayden. That's going to be Hayden's fourth personal foul. Coming with 3:56 to play in this game. India Atkins heading to the free throw line. She's got 14 points in the second half, 20 points in the ball game, and this will be her first trip to the free throw line tonight.
Let's go, Cole. Want that ball.
Atkins sends it on the way. It's good. India with 21. Second shot by Atkins. It's good. Lady Colts lead down to 9. Back to single digits at 61-52 with 3:50 to play in the game. Hardy has it to Fuller. To Jarrah Cotton at the free throw line. Cotton wants to attack. Gets around the defender. Lays it up and in. And she's going to be fouled in the act of shooting. Tough, tough basket by Jarrah Cotton. Townsend's call for her third. Cotton's going to the free throw line to try to complete the three-point play. Lady Colts on top by 11, 63-52. Cotton heads to the free throw line. Her first trip tonight. That shot's on the way. In and out, no good. National Park has it with 3:35 to go in the game, down by 11. They'll work it right side. Townsend has it out beyond the arc. Atkins tries to attack, gives it back to Townsend for three. That one's in there. Sydney Townsend with her first three of the night. She's got 7. Lady Colts lead back to single digits. And a violation coming across that line. The Lady Colts inbound it, but turn it over. Unforced turnover, and National Park gets it back. We've got a time. We had a buzzer there for some reason. Three-pointer on the way by India Atkins. Atkins nails it in the confusion. And let's see here. We've got a timeout. Lady Colts down by 5, or up by 5, 63-58, 3:08 to go. We've got a full timeout. We're back in a moment after this from State Farm.
Psst. Hey, Jake from State Farm. I want that personal price plan. So how's this for personal? I draw mustaches on players' faces when they're asleep.
Coach Reed, you don't need to get that personal to get the State Farm Personal Price Plan. It helps you create an affordable price just for you.
Oh.
Coach, it happened again.
I'm gonna get to the bottom of this.
Call or click to get a quote today. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Lady Colts basketball on 888 being brought to you tonight by Pilgrims and by Husqvarna. Timeout on the court. Lady Colts on top, 63-58. As the Lady Colts had turned it over on the inbounds play after a National Park basket, and then they hit a three-pointer after an inadvertent buzzer. Cuts it to five. We said there's still plenty of time to go in this one. 3:08 left in the game. Lady Colts left Jared Cotton, Kyler Hardy, Kiana Holly, Samari Smith, and Carmella Hayden in the lineup. Out front, that's Hayden. She'll back it out. Under 3 minutes to go now. Hayden has it. And she's going to be called for the travel up top. Lady Colts, another turnover. Back-to-back turnovers. National Park with an opportunity to cut into that five-point lead. Just under 3 minutes to go in this game. India Atkins has it. Cross court to Townsend. Looking underneath, all alone, shot up and in. Well, actually shot no good, but Samaya Smith is going to be called for the personal foul. So Smith is called for her first. Rather than give up the easy basket, Smith chose to foul, and going to the free throw line will be Cornisha Griffin. This will be Cornisha's first free throw attempts of the evening. Griffin has not scored tonight and still hasn't, as that one's off the iron, no good. That actually turns out to be a good foul, as this shot's on the way and it's good. But Griffin only gets one when she could have had an easy two right there. Lady Colts on top by four, 63-59. Hayden, as Jared Cotton hits the deck away from the basketball. Lady Colts have it. That's Smith. Smith works it right side to Hayden. Hayden working against India Atkins. 10 seconds on the shot clock. Out to Smith in the corner. Three-pointer on the way by Holly! Kiana Holly! That's her first points of the night, and it's a big, big three. We got a travel called on India Atkins. Wow. National Park turns it over with 2:06 to go in this game. But still a lot of time here. Kiana Holly, who hit like, I don't know, 3 three-pointers against National Park last time out, gets her first points of the night, and it couldn't have come at a better time. Hardy has it, drives inside the lane, goes strong to the basket, whistle foul. Is that on Townsend? No, yes. Sydney Townsend called for her fourth personal foul. Kyler Hardy's heading to the free throw line. So Hardy heads to the charity stripe. She's got a dozen points in the ball game. She's actually 3 out of 6 to make it 4 out of 7 at the free throw line tonight. Actually, she's 5 out of 8 at the free throw line. Second shot's on the way. 6 out of 9. Wait a minute. Lady Colts were in the lane. They're going to wipe that one off. So take that one off the court, off the scoreboard, and Lady Colts on top. With a minute 52 to play, we've got a timeout on the court. Our score, Lady Colts 67, National Park 59. Back in a moment on 888radio.com.
It's in the smallest details, the answer. How is Husqvarna chainsaw durable and at the same time lightweight? And how can an XP chainsaw from Husqvarna help you work both faster and safer? It's in all those small engineered details. Husqvarna, ready when you are.
Minute 52 to go in the ball game. Lady Colts clinging to an 8-point lead, 67-59. National Park trailed by as many as 18 points in that first half. Have been as close as what? 4 points in the second half? Yeah. India Atkins with it as they cross the midcourt stripe. She works it over to Calvin. He deep in that left corner. Pleasance fires it on the way. Can't get it to go. The rebound Tough shot underneath. Can't get it to go. The rebound comes off to National Park. They get it back out to Townsend. Townsend fires up a long three. Can't get that one to go. Atkins chases down the long rebound. Long three-pointer by National Park. That one's an air ball out of bounds. National Park had four shots at it. Couldn't get it to go. And the Lady Colts will have it back on top. 67-59 with a minute 24 to go in the game, facing full court pressure. They'll get it to Hardy, and Hardy will jog it down court. Gets it up to Smith. Samaya has it in the front court. A minute 10 to go in the game. Pleasant's putting pressure on the basketball. Smith gets it to Hardy. Fires it ahead to Holly. Lays it up and in. Give Holly the basket. Hardy the assist. Lady Colts back on top by 10. Under a minute to go. Lady Colts with a double-digit lead. Townsend has it. They're working right side to Atkins. Deep in the corner for three. No good. Rebound picked up by National Park. That shot no good. Rebound out of bounds off of National Park. 46.6 to go in the game. Lady Colts on top by 10. As Hardy gets it in to Hayden. Hayden working in the backcourt. Gets it over to Hardy. Hardy jogs it into the front court. Lady Colts have it. 38 seconds to go in the game. Pleasants comes out. They'll give it to Holly. Holly facing pressure out there by Atkins. Atkins hits the deck. Goes to Hayden. Hayden drives, has her shot blocked underneath. Ball goes out of bounds. Last touch by Hayden. 24.8 to go. Lady Colts on top, 69-59. And you can kind of breathe a little easier right now as Atkins will pick it up at the midcourt stripe. Clock running down to 20 seconds to go. And that pass out of bounds. Not touched by anyone. Lady Colts get it back. 69-59. Lady Colts looking to move on in this tournament. They'll get it ahead to Smith. Samaya drives in the lane, lays it up, can't get it to go. Rebound comes off to National Park's Jyla Calvin. Pass midcourt stripe, India Atkins has it. In traffic, 6 seconds to go in the ballgame. That one's into the backcourt. Kiana Holly picks it up, lays it up at the buzzer, can't get it to go though. Final score, Lady Colts 69, National Park 59. Back to wrap it up in a moment on N88Radio.com.
Boring chicken special on Salt Lake.
My parents are feeding us boring chicken again.
Mobilize all units.
I worry about my little sister.
Put that down, sir. Step away from the microwave. Pilgrim's Chicken. Try it today. It'll kick the boring right out of you.
Hope to come back, all right? Don't even hope to come back.
Did you hear that? The State Farm thing. Da-da-da-da-da. I think we're in a commercial.
Jake from State Farm, I knew it.
Don't worry, Chris. Things are gonna go surprisingly great.
Dad, look!
Christmas!
See? Surprising. Just like State Farm's surprisingly great rates.
I didn't even record.
Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
In DeQuain, your State Farm insurance agent is Luke Billingsley at 870-642-2157.
Final score, Lady Colts win it 69-59 in opening round action of the NJCAA. Division II, Region II tournament here at the Bank of Locksburg Historic Gymnasium. As Lady Colts were led tonight, 25 points for Kayla Fuller, including 5 3-pointers in that second half. Meanwhile, 13 points in the ball game tonight for Kyler Hardy. Samaya Smith had a dozen on the evening. Looks like 6 points for Amari Morrison, anxious to see exactly what that ankle looks like overnight. 5 points tonight for Kiana Holly. Those were late in the ball game, and those were big, big baskets, including a three-pointer. 4 points each for Jared Cotton and Carmella Hayden. Meanwhile, India Atkins of National Park, and she had like 6 points at the half, exploded for 19 more in the second half, wound up with 25 points in the ball game. 14 points for Jyla Calvin, 12 for Ashley Blaylock, 7 points tonight for Sydney Townsend, and 1 point for Carnesha Griffin. Again, that final score, Lady Colts win at 69-59, and they'll move on in the Region 2 tournament, as I believe that Saturday afternoon they'll be down in East Camden to take on SAU Tech. Second round action, SAU Tech, undefeated in conference play. They got the top seed in the tournament. They got a first round bye, and they'll face the Lady Colts on Saturday. Meanwhile, we'll be back on the air again tomorrow. Got a long road trip tomorrow. Going to be traveling all day long up to North Arkansas, going to Harrison to take on the Pioneers. And the Colts men's team will take on the Pioneers. That's a 6 o'clock tip-off tomorrow night, and you can catch all the action right here on ed88radio.com. Well, for Kelly Plunk, who was on the camera tonight, for all of our sponsors, I'm Lauren Hinton. Thanking you for joining us tonight. We'll catch you again tomorrow night on ed88radio.com.